The holidays are upon us, and so are the family dinners.
Jennifer Phelps, Miss Fix-It, is here to share the best ways to make any gathering organized and successful.
That's right.
We want the success part.
That's right. And you know, the thing is, it's all kinds of parties. So you have big family gatherings, you have all kinds of little ones of all different types as well. So this is the time that we really want to get going. And what's interesting is sometimes you want to spice things up a little from traditional recipes or make them more healthy. Two places that I love to go for that are justapinch.com and Pinterest, because sometimes just changing the presentation a touch makes a beautiful table without any more effort. So that's something to consider as well.
Good places to go.
Yeah. And so then the pros and cons of having a potluck. One, of course, people sometimes go back and forth about whether or not to have a potluck or do it all themselves. So what's nice is, one, it's obviously less cooking and less expense for the host. That's one thing to consider. But also, at these types of gatherings, it helps people feel a part of the family and part of the community. And if you ask Auntie Myrtle to bring her famous dish, you know, that's a point of pride as well. So it's a really nice way to make it easier for you and also help people feel included. So that's always really nice. And sometimes you've noticed that you get all your food out, whether you've made it yourself or you've done a potluck, and you don't know how to fit on the table, and it looks like chaos and a mishmash. Exactly.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, you know what it looks like. You do all this work, and then it's like, oh, gosh, it looks terrible. My table looks terrible. Well, here are just some fun things actually going up. Multi-use centerpieces. So, for example, this is cute for desserts or whatever. Sorry, there aren't actual cupcakes. But I'm in love with this one. And then also, little trays like this help you serve here, and you still have room for dishes below. So really helping to elevate and things like that. And it looks beautiful as well. For example, this, you can put all of your utensils in one place, for example, or you can use it for condiments, and that's also a really great way to change up the tabletop and make it look really pretty. So that's something you can do. Now, a lot of people want to know, oh, and there's another one over here. See the ice bucket?
Yep.
You can use those little plastic chillers, or you can make your own ice cubes with non-staining dye. And you can use your ice bucket and your ice and cool pretty colored ice as part of your centerpiece as well, because you're going to have it out. You might as well make it beautiful. So that's another way to make your table look pretty with something you're going to have on it anyway.
I love that. If you're going to have it out, might as well make it beautiful.
And sometimes it doesn't take much more to do that, and you'll feel better as well. And now one of the other things that's big for a party is setting up that food line, which totally becomes chaos. And whether you're having a casual party or a formal party, the principles of setting up a food line are the same. So, for example, so you don't want everyone filling their plates with your prime expensive pieces, like your rib roast right off the top, right? So you start with your breads and starches, move on to your veggies and sides, and then you put your meats and stuff toward the end because there's less room on the plate. Yeah. Exactly.
I'm going to be thinking about that the next line I'm in.
That's right.
And so you put the turkey in front.
Yeah. Just kidding.
And make sure you have enough utensils, and also make sure that all the condiments needed for each dish are either all at the end or next to the dish that you're going to use it for. Desserts and drinks separately, because here's the thing. When you do a food line, you want to make sure you know where people are going to eat. If they're going to be in the dining room or outside, you want the end of your food line to be in that direction. So you start it. You work your way backwards so that people end where they're going to eat, so they're not crissing and crossing on their way in and out, because that makes for total chaos at your party. And so even small spaces, you can think about it and plan ahead. If you have a potluck, take those dishes from your guests and place them where you want them on that potluck table, and it will really help cut down the chaos. One thing I thought was really cool, this little deal over here, this crock pot hookup. Mm-hmm. A lot of times also you have a lot of hot dishes and only one outlet, because counter space and outlets are at a premium. Those, you buy them and connect them, and there's only one outlet.
Okay, so we can heat more than one dish.
That's right, and you can put them all in one place. And then the very last thing that I think is always fun is when helping kids have fun and entertain themselves, but also how to take home leftovers. I have this on the show every time. The little Chinese containers, you can get them from food service supply stores, a huge sleeve for, I think there's 50 or 200 of them for $5. It's kind of a wide range of
somewhere in there.
But anyway, it's well worth the money, and the kids can decorate them, and then you can send stuff home with people as well while they're taking their dishes home, and you're not doing the dishes because you did a potluck or whatever, and everyone's happy. And the thing to remember is people are forgiving. Don't feel like you have to totally stress out. Your guests want you to be there with them and having a good time. If you have your, you know, condiments in the wrong place, so what? That's the least of the worries. Enjoy your guests, enjoy your time, and have a really great party. Happy Thanksgiving and happy Hanukkah.
And happy. She's covering them all. And you can also learn more tips online at miss-fix-it.com, or you can hire a professional organizer or Jennifer by visiting TucsonProfessionalOrganizers.com. And happy holidays to you as well.
Thank you.